we have the situation, a very modern situation, because we have a product we want to sell, and we look what is the wish of the market, what wants the market, and then we try to make the product in a shape that it fits to the market. But we should be careful, because here we have to do something with an animal. So it's not like a car. And that's a problem. It's the first step how you can destroy a horse, because the calm, basic work is so important. When the horse knows the aids, then I take the lunge off and let the rider free. And then a horse, after 3 months, he just knows to go long lines. He knows to do this in walk, trot, rising trot, never sit in the beginning, and a little bit canter. And that's all, nothing more. And always with the neck long, nose forward.
Inexperienced riders often believe that auxiliary reins help to achieve success faster. Generally speaking, however, it only brings the horse into a forced posture and on the long term increases the problem significantly.
People think this horse is already in a round position. So he's under control, he's round, it's much better. And some of them even think this horse works with the back because he's round. The horse gets very supple, and also the big joints of the hind legs, they start to work. And first of all, we do them in walk, because the horse can coordinate his body the best in walk, because he has time to understand. And all of us, we can give the aids much better in walk than in trot or canter, because we can sit very well in walk and we can give our aids very precise. So this is the first step to collect the horse. And you can imagine the horse now, he learns to move like this. And the step to move like this is so short. For us, it's not something we do at the end of the story. It's an exercise we use to help the horse. We traveled around and we filmed horses when they competed, so in warm-up arenas and even during the tests. And as we didn't want to tell, this rider is not good and that rider made a bad job, we made out of these films, trick films. So it's not a diagonal movement at all, so it's not Piaf. And if you watch the blue hind leg, you can see sometimes makes a circle in the air. And the red hind leg, never ever. You see the circle of the blue one? The red one, no. We repeat. Now, the blue one, circle in the air, down. The red one, no. Now, circle in the air and down. This is called what they call in circus balancé. Sometimes in circus, when you have a horse with a Piaf without expression, you start to kick a little left and right, but the horse moves like this because for the public looks nice. Here you have a trot in extension. Is the first mistake, the rider is behind the vertical. Second thing is the nose of the horse is also behind the verticals. And you see the red one stays a little bit longer in the air than the blue one, the red hind leg. Look, the blue one goes, and now again, the red one stays a little. You have seen a normal trot in extension on the right, and one moves much higher, but it's a broken diagonal. Here you see a big difference already in the hind leg. This is far away, the croup is up. So you see the right horse, he's making meters, he's going on. The front legs go up, forward, down, never backwards. The other one, they make funny movements with the front legs, with the red one a little, with the right one not so funny, with the red front leg a little bit funny, up. And there's no power from behind, it's just lift a little the legs. So for me, it's a complete misunderstanding of dressage, because dressage should help the horse to stay healthy, to find his balance, to get very fine, and it doesn't exist to destroy a horse. And if we don't understand enough of movements and how the exercises should look like, sometimes it's enough if you look at the face of a horse. If you see the faces, they tell you all. So mostly it's not necessary to watch the legs. Just watch this and you know what's going on.